Okay, part three. Is she gonna get on this freaking horse? This is crazy to me if she does. Maybe she's just desensitizing, but.
Good girl. If she jumps, bucks, or rears up right now, then it's okay. Then that's her right because I'm asking her a question and she's free to answer the way she wants. I don't want her to rear up a buck. I want her to stand still and to accept it. But she is free when I'm training her, so she has the right to walk away and go to her corner. And back up for me. Good girl.
She almost hit that horse in the face with that
Corner.
whip. Get rid of that
And
damn
back up
whip,
for me.
women. You don't need it. Right here, way too close to this horse's eye. Come on. You don't need that. She could have asked the horse nicely without that damn whip.
Good girl.
Good girl. Good girl. That horse, this horse is guessing right now. What does she want?
And back up for me.
This horse doesn't know backup. Doesn't know. It's like, do you want my head up? Do you want. This horse is asking, what do you want? And the horse guesses. And she says, good girl, because she thinks she taught it.
Good girl.
Horse almost ran.
That's right. It's okay. Come on. Try it again.
Okay. So the horse was going to
Good
run
girl.
here. She saw it. She backed away. She gives a little
Okay.
release to draw. Come with
Come
me,
on.
come with me, come with
Try
me. But the horse is confused
Good
here. Thinks
girl.
he's getting pressure, 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 pressure,
Okay.
pressure. Finally, she
Come on.
turns away and gives a little draw, release of pressure, and the horse goes, okay, I'll follow you if you're not giving me pressure. I just don't know what you want. This horse is screaming, it's
Try it
confused.
again. Good girl. She has the right to say no. And I want to give her that right. Because the second she agrees to do this, then I know it's for real. Then I know I can trust her. And then I.
Then I know I can trust her. I don't trust this horse yet. I've watched you walk. I don't trust this horse
I know
yet.
that she is okay with being ridden.
The horse doesn't trust you. There's no trust here. Only in your mind.
And I don't want to ride a horse that hasn't chosen or accepted.
Holy shit, I can't believe she jumped on the damn horse. Sometimes luck is better than freaking knowledge. Oh my God, are you kidding me?
A rider. I would ride.
Oh my God, this woman is freaking crazy. Rick, she's better than you. And just because you wouldn't do it because you're scared. Whatever. I'm just smart. I'm not scared. I just think this is a foolish move. I don't jump out of planes without a parachute to show how smart I am. All right? What the hell? Are you kidding me?
Rather have a horse that is calm.
Okay, she got off good. I'm glad she got off good.
That
Before this
allow
horse could pick up speed, this horse is saying no. Look at this
to
horse's
ride a horse
tail.
that
Watch
hasn't
this.
chosen
No, what the hell are you doing, woman? Are you crazy with this horse's
or
ears?
accept
Confused. Holy shit, this crazy woman just jumped on me.
that
Is she crazy? Mouth. Rick,
to
she's
ride a
lipping.
horse
If
that
her lips
hasn't
move, she's
chosen
learning. What did this
or
horse
accept
learn right here? Look at the lips, Rick. Rick, I saw a tongue. The horse. Oh, look, the horse is learning. This is an aggressive. This is a threatening aggressive. This is not lip licking nice people. This is what the hell are you doing? This is showing teeth and getting aggressive. This girl jumped off at a good freaking time.
a rider.
You better get off me. What the?
I would
Starts to move
rather
away.
have a
As
horse.
soon as she feels it to start to trot, she knows she's in trouble. She's not as dumb as people may think she is. And I don't know if she's, I mean, I think she's crazy to jump on this horse, but she's got some horse knowledge because she's doing some things, but she's still trapped. This horse could turn right now and kick her very easily.
That is calm and
And then she
hasn't.
moves to the corner to where the horse could really turn and trap her in this corner. I don't like putting myself in positions like this.
Completely accept.
Look at that slap. Come on, woman.
I would rather have a
Jesus
horse that is
Christ.
calm and has completely accepted.
Damn. What the? Somebody teach this woman what feel and softness is. Feel, lady. There's different types. There's soft touch. There's the fine hair. There's where the hair connects. There's soft touch. You're slapping a horse hard that is not comfortable. It is almost like a correction. It's shocking. It doesn't feel good. It doesn't matter if you connect it with good girl and you slap the shit out of your horse. Are you kidding me?
Expected. I'm
Damn!
still saying no.
You slap me like that, I'd be like, what the hell is wrong with you? Aggressive. Aggressive.
Please, expect.
Slap! Aggressive.
Still
Hands up,
saying no.
snap! Face! Aggressive! She wanted the horse stop. She put pressure.
Leave it for a while.
So she told the horse to stop, but she's creating a draw and backing away.
Leave it for a while.
So the horse, is the horse learning here? Is it guessing? Because earlier when she backed away, she wanted to create a draw. She wanted the horse to come in. Now she's backing away. She wants it to stop. How's the horse supposed to know that? Well, Rick, she put her hands up so the horse will know. But the horse hasn't learned that. The horse is still guessing. They haven't created a language to where she does anything consistent. The only consistent thing she does is swing that damn whip around a horse's face. That is it. And she slaps the horse too damn hard. She's consistent on that. This horse, I see total confusion, uneasiness, and frustration. This horse is not learning. He's trying to learn. He's trying to figure out what the right answer is. Kissing and clicking, all that means nothing now because she uses it when the horse follows or walks or stands or.
Stand. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl.
So she's ready to jump off. Now remember, somebody may think you can do this in an open area and this is okay. There's a camera guy, whoever working the camera, creating pressure. And she's been working in this corner to where this horse, it appears, is kind of trapped in this one area. So this horse knows it can't just run off free right now. So she kind of set it up that if you're getting on it in a small area, even in a round pen, a horse could run and could toss you off. So that I wouldn't recommend. I just don't think this is a good idea. She gives the horse the ability to run off buck or make her get off. And that's not good. If I get on a horse, I want to be able to control the horse's feet. She's not controlling the horse's feet. She is riding. She is not driving or steering. That is not a position of dominance, and it's not a position of teaching a horse that you're in control. This horse is guessing, confused, and frustrated, but the horse is in control of its feet, and that's not what you want to have happen when you're trying to establish a relationship with a horse. I really disagree with what she's doing here. Although I applaud her fearlessness and her ability to get on it and her confidence that she can get off it and she's not going to get hurt. I like that about her, but I don't think it's smart to work with this horse and to teach the horse good lessons.
Easy. 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 Good girl. Good girl.
So, does she know how to stop this horse? Can she stop this horse right now? I'm thinking no.
Girl. Good girl. She's okay with me being up here.
I don't think she is okay. Her tail and her head's going up and down and she's sniffing. I don't think she is
But
okay.
she's not listening and I can't stop her. Which also again tells me that in riding with people on her back, she will take the control in riding as well.
Are you kidding me? That's not telling you the horse will take control. You have no way to control her. Why are you blaming the horse for not listening to you? You have no way to communicate with her except through your human voice, and you think your horse talks your language. Come on,
She has
people.
learned that she's stronger than people are.
Look at that tail. Look at those ears.
Oh, good girl. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Ah, can't stop her. Can't stop her.
So here she tried to put pressure on the front of the horse by putting her heels there, thinking that would do it. She's trying stuff and she's saying, I can't stop her. I said that before she ever got on the damn horse. Why would you get on a horse you can't control? Horse is in control. She gets on it and teaches the horse that I don't have to listen to you, that you're not in control. Her, she's been saying this whole time that the horse doesn't listen. The horse wants to be wild. The horse, she's not teaching the horse or giving what I call a fair shake to the horse.
Whoa.
She's teaching the horse bad lessons. And she's blaming the horse for learning them.
Stop her.
So she gets off a horse while the horse is walking. What did the horse learn? This is when you're working with horses, you always have to ask after every event or everything that happened, what did the horse just learn? What do you think the horse learned here? Some people will see, well, the horse learned that it's okay to let a rider sit on you, and that she was brave and strong and powerful for getting up there, Rick, and it shows that she knows what she's doing. And these are all the idiots that want to see a strong, powerful woman and want to believe this shit, that this is good. What I see the horse learned is, when you get on top of me, I still get to do what I want. I don't have to listen to you. I'll just keep walking because I'm frustrated. And sooner or later, you'll get off. What did the horse learn that helped or hurt your position as the leader in this relationship? Did it help, and maybe not even your leadership position, did it help the relationship? Some people will say it did because the horse let her ride. I don't know if that's true. I mean, a little bit, yeah. The horse didn't buck, didn't flip over, didn't run and try to throw her off, didn't start kicking and stomping his feet and rearing. That's all true. But is that really progress, or did I really teach it that? Or is it just the horse doesn't want to buck and do all that? The horse, I didn't push the horse to a big enough fear position that it felt it needed to do that. So it kind of just walked around until I got off it. Not good, in my opinion.
Can't stop her. She's a machine and I can't stop her.
I can't stop her. I can't. Stupid horse just won't let me stop her. I agree with this woman. You can't stop her doing what you're doing. If you do what you are doing, you're right. You can't stop her. Is it impossible to stop her? Absolutely not. Raise your hand if you think I can't stop this horse from walking forward. Of course I could. I wouldn't jump on its back with no rope or nothing to control the horse. Then I couldn't stop it. But I'm not going to put myself in a position to where I can't win or be in a dominant or controlling position with a horse that I'm trying to show that I'm a strong leader and that it needs to respect me. There's a difference between respect and just show him who's boss, dominate him, treat him like shit, slap him, kiss him, tell him you love him. Oh, now she's got her whip. Now she's back in control. Notice the response. Now the horse understands. Rip, see, Rick, the whip really makes the horse understand. Well, that's because you're an idiot.
I never use a bit because I feel like it's too big of a compromise. Really, I feel it's an illusion.
Good for her. See, now I like her. Before, I was like, she don't know what she's doing. She doesn't use a bit. That's smart. I like that about her.
Because if you can't control your horse, then a bit is not going to help you anyways. A bit is going to create pain.
Man, see, me and this girl are kind of eye and eye on some things.
In the horse's mouth.
She's still very aggressive. Do y'all see the way she is with his horse? See, I think some people see this as confidence, and I just see it as lack of feel, timing, and sensitivity. She's so busy about showing that she can do whatever she wants to do, and she has the power to do what she wants to do. And instead of using that power limiting the power that she uses, or toning down the power and knowing that I can get more with less, but because she doesn't have to use less, she's just aggressive and rough with this horse.
If you can't control your horse,
she does not have soft hands. Aggressive.
Then a bit is not going to help you anyways. A bit is going to create pain in the
aggressive.
Horse's mouth.
Tight in, yanking.
In case it doesn't
yanking.
Listen and you are in need of really using it. But
come on, girl. There's no point in what she's doing.
But it's not going to help you in real danger, though.
I like that this strap is far enough around where it's not really close. Sometimes I see this strap right here by the eye, and I don't like that. So this strap's nice and low. I like that. This looks like some sort of side pull bitless bridle. I've said before, I'm not a fan of the reins on the side. I like the connections underneath the chin where they're both there. I think it gives better, clearer direction for the horse. On the side, I don't like it.
The horse will just take over and run anyway through the pain. But if you get the horse to choose to listen to you, then you can control them in anything. And because there's no bit in this bridle, then I feel like I can communicate in a much better way with the horse. I can make a simple question like this, please stop for me. If she doesn't, I can do it a little harder, please stop. And if she really doesn't, then I will have to train her and say, hey, I'm...
So what? This is really great for demonstrating what she does with a horse. What did she just teach the horse, people? This horse is standing here and allowing her to do all
this.
A
little harder, please stop. And if she really doesn't, then I will have to train her and say, hey, I mean...
Ambushed. Negative training. You just taught the horse something that you don't even know what you taught it. You don't know why you did it, but you're so caught up in explaining how you do shit that you make this horse pay for your ignorance. Sorry, Mia. That was an ignorant move. Wish you hadn't done that. Not impressed.
Make a simple question like this.
Now she's showing softness. Feel. I'm with her.
Please stop for me. If she doesn't, I can do it.
Ambush. What is this horse thinking right now?
Make a simple
Look.
Question like this.
Oh, she gave me a little pressure and I yielded. That must be the right answer. No, it's not the right answer, you stupid horse. Because the only thing the horse knows, he doesn't know she's training. Only thing the horse knows is when I listen to her soft, now she snaps me.
I can do it a little.
Wow, I wonder what she wanted. What do you think the horse thinks she wants? The horse is like, I don't know, I'm confused. I'll just ignore everything on my mouth because 1 minute she was soft, next minute she slapped me. Now she's going to slap me harder.
And if she really doesn't, then I will have to train her and say, hey, I mean stop. But still, even though I'm a little harsh right now, then she will feel like a little shock reaction, but I can't break anything.
Active tail, tight reins. I don't like this.
And a lot of horses think, especially if they have this pattern of being so strong as this.
This pattern of being, the horse has the pattern of being strong. My guess is every horse that she works with has the same pattern.
Girl, then she have felt the pain of the bit many times. Good girl.
No, she said good girl. Now the horse knows she likes her.
I can steer her, but I can't seem to stop her. And I feel like every time I put a pressure, just a little question to stop her, then she begins to move faster. And now...
Obviously you can't stop her when you do it right. Obviously you can. Maybe you did it right there. Maybe you need to learn what the horse understands.
She stopped, so that was good.
Oh, I like that. I do like this horse.
And now she stopped, so that was good.
Okay, so I'm trying to figure out what she did to get this reaction.
And now
she wanted
stopped,
to go
so
forward, but I didn't see if she kicked it. So what did she do here to get this kick? I want to watch the legs. So I'm really, I don't see what she did to get this. Was it a click? I can't tell if she gave it pressure with the legs.
See, now she's testing my leadership from the back a little bit. Back it up. Good girl. Good girl.
She gets a good girl for that? Okay, let's take a look at this again.
See.
This is what I call bracing. This is what happens when you don't understand that when you pull straight back on reins, you brace the horse's head straight and you give up power. That's why I always teach people to ride with one rein, because they can't show this toughness. I'm going to pull on two reins. they have to pull on only one rein. And guess what happens when you pull on one rein? The horse's head can't brace between two reins, and he turns his head. And you take away his ability to see forward, to go forward, and to run and do a lot of things. So by learning to ride with one rein, you have to learn softness and feelness. Because if you just pull on one rein like she's pulling on two, the horse just turns his head and you go in circles. But that is a cheat, and people need two reins so they can feel powerful, strong, empowered, and they think they control the horse. She's teaching the horse to brace. This horse could stop a lot easier if she just pulled one rein. Right here. She was about to bail. She was ready to bail. It stopped bucking, so she stayed on. And then she pulled straight back and braced the horse. And it didn't stop the horse. This is where some people will say if she had a bit, she could have caused a horse to stop because it would have hurt him. You don't want to stop a horse with pain because sometimes that'll make him rear or even run with more pain. Although it works, it's not good. But you can't stop them also by bracing on two reins and just putting pressure on their
See,
nose.
now she's testing my leadership from the back a little bit. Back it up.
See, she's keeping the horse's head straight. The horse is trying to turn to find a release of pressure. This is how you end up getting a horse to rear over. If you keep giving pressure, 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 and the horse can't figure out the answer, she wants it to back up. If the horse backs up, she'll probably release. But because you didn't teach the horse that he doesn't know the right answer, he's trying to figure it out. And hopefully, if you're lucky, he'll try backing for you to release pressure. But if he doesn't try backing and he tries twisting his head, raising his head, lowering his head, and then he tries rearing, that's how you get a horse to flip over or fall on you, and you say the horse is crazy. Big difference.
Good girl.
Good
good
girl.
girl
Really?
so I'm telling her
Really?
the same deal goes from her
Release! The horses, release! Release the pressure! Release the Kraken! Don't keep pulling on the reins. The horse has stopped. He did the right answer. Give the horse release.
back.
She said he did the right answer, and she has yet to release the pressure off the horse's face. Horses learn on release.
I am not going to hit her screw
The horse is still looking for release. That's why he's doing his head.
from
This
her
head bob
back.
is, why are you
I
pulling?
am
What do you
not
want? I'm confused. Still pulling.
going to
Still
hit
pulling.
her screwing
Still
myself
pulling.
or do anything
Still
else.
pulling.
But the thing
Still
I told
pulling.
her
Still
on the ground,
pressure. Pressure. The
I'm
horse
gonna
doesn't
back her
know.
up 2 steps.
Now the horse figures out, okay, I guess the right answer is when this crazy human keeps pulling and pulling on me, that I turn my head and walk off. She taught the horse the wrong answer and she doesn't even know it. Mia, you're a horse trainer, but you train bad things to a horse.
Just like I did from the ground. And I don't want to ride her with a lot of pressure. So I'm letting her go loose. She can't even feel I'm touching her right now.
That's absolutely untrue. She can totally feel that rein is not looping.
Letting her go loose.
This lane rein is loose. This rein is not loose. See the loop? That's how you know it's loose. She's not. She's giving pressure. She doesn't even know it. She thinks that she's loose right now. When I said she doesn't have feel or softness and she's aggressive, she thinks she's going to tell you right now she's on loose reins.
Loose. She can't even feel I'm touching her right now.
Yes, she does.
And only when I want to communicate something to her, then I will give her a signal.
She's got the words and phrases down. She does not apply it correctly. I'm sorry, Mia. I'm sorry, all the women that I'm hurting your feelings right now. She just doesn't.
And as you can see, she will begin to lick and chew even
Here we go with the licking and chewing again. Good grief.
when I'm riding her, just like she did from the ground. She will talk back to me. She will give
She's talking back the whole time. Her tail isn't hit. Her head isn't relaxed. She's guessing. She's confused. She's trying to figure out what the hell you want. You're not clear, so she doesn't know, and she continues to guess. And luckily, neither one of you have hurt the other one yet.
Me her acceptance. And whoa. Stand. Stand. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Need to be able to be alive on your back. Good girl.
damn slap.
To be
slapping the
to be
damn horse, woman!
Back. Good girl.
Jesus. Look at the horse flinch when she slaps. When a horse flinches, it's never good.
To be
watch the flinch
to be alive
on the slap.
Back. Good girl.
Jesus Christ. Tail.
Such a good girl. I will advise the owners of this horse to let this horse stay here for a little longer.
Shocking. A trainer that says your horse needs more training. I've never heard that one before. Who else has taken their horse to a trainer and a trainer said, oh, this horse did so good in the first couple days, I don't need it anymore. Yeah. Trainers don't stay in business that way, people.
Because I can see she understands the training, but there is a bit of a... There's still a bit more work to do before this horse is completely done.
You got a hell of a lot of work to do on yourself.
But she has moved a long way. If you think about this is her second day in training. I mean, then I can't ask for any more than what she's giving me.
I can ask for a whole lot more than what she's giving you because you ain't asking right and you're not getting your timing release and ensuring that the horse is learning something. The horse is guessing the entire time I've watched you work with this horse. The horse is guessing.
Me.
Day two, meeting with the owners.
Good girl. Handstand. Good.
In the land of the blind, the man with one eye is king. Okay? And let me translate that for you. If you don't know enough about your horse, horsemanship, and horse behavior, then you're going to believe anybody that explains it to where it looks like they know more than you. Therefore, they will be king because you're living in the land of the blind. The only way that you get better is you learn, you understand, you put into practice, and then you get it. Confucius said, if I hear, I forget. If I see, I remember. If I do, I understand. If you have others do, you will never understand.
Trot. Good girl. It is a little bit too small for her in here. Come on. Just trot carefully and don't fall. Good girl, easy over here.
It is amazing that she been like that. This,
this is amazing. Rick, why are you picking on her? I'm just saying, this girl could not get any results with the horse because she knows less than the trainer. And now that the horse did something that she couldn't do, in her eyes, this trainer is good and is a horse whisperer.
It's a totally different horse. She looked much more happy when I look at her. I can see it in her eyes.
See, I don't think...
She may see a little happiness because the horse is less confused with her than she is with you. Because she knows a little more than you, the horse has figured her out or figured out how to work with her with less stress because she's more clear than you. I can only imagine how bad you are as the owner. Because this horse is like just a sweet horse with a whole bunch of try. There is absolutely nothing wrong with this horse. This is not a horse problem at all.
Think this horse has ever made a choice by herself in her life before?
No.
I don't think that her earlier riding experiences has been good at all.
I always think she'd have a bad
beginning.
Yeah.
See, this is how women are connecting in the horse world. Oh, it feels so good. We can talk about it. And it's our emotions and we're sharing our feelings. And I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that, people. I don't care if women want to be women and share feelings. I'm just saying when you get it involved with horses, it impedes learning and growth and progress. This has nothing to do. This horse's past doesn't matter. It only cares what you do. This owner doesn't do right because she doesn't know. Therefore, the horse is confused and frustrated and fights and is always like, I don't trust you because you're not clear. So she traces it to a trainer, and a trainer can be a little more clear. The horse shows a little progress, and suddenly these two think they're both horse whisperers, and she found a great trainer, and this is a great trainer.
Yeah.
I don't buy it.
Yeah, I think so too. Riding hasn't been fun. And if she couldn't make a choice, then she would rather not be a riding horse at all.
Yeah.
Yeah. Having her making a decision that she really wants it again. Yeah. All over, a whole new start. Oh, it's your turn.
Okay.
Come in here.
Oh, super. It's her turn. I was going to stop it, but...
It's the hand that you're leading her by. Just imagine you have an invisible...
How much more time we got here?
Invisible lead rope hanging here.
We got 4 minutes. I kind of want to see her. Let me see if I want to do another one. Okay, I can make this. I'll just make this one longer. Okay, this last one will be longer. I don't know if I get another 30 minutes out of this to do a part four, but I just watched like 20 seconds of this, and there's a couple things I want to point out, which is good.
Yep, very good.
Okay, so this girl walks very stiff. She's got her hands out. She's got a rope. She doesn't really... what I call softness or comfortableness with the horse. She's only doing what she's told. See how it's almost robotic walk? This comes from insecurity, lack of doing it. She doesn't trust the horse. The horse doesn't really trust her. So she's listening to the trainer, and the trainer told her to do something. This will soften up as she gets better and more experience, but this is why the horse was giving her problems. Unfortunately, when this works, this girl will think the whip is a must-have now. I don't know if she used a whip before. Maybe she did and she didn't use it. I don't know.
You're very good at using your body language.
Okay, so the trainer's giving her good positive feedback. Okay, I'm good with that.
Very good.
Mia... I hope you don't think I was too mean on you.
I don't feel like she's dangerous to me anymore.
No. No. That's very important. That's a very good achievement to feel that she's not dangerous.
Okay, Mia, I'm going to give you a compliment here. You are better with people than horses on your softness and sensitivity and communication. If you talk that way to a horse, you would get better. See, Mia is good at verbal communication, and that's why she's better. She's not good at horse body language, softness, and feel, and rhythm, and touch with horses. Work on that, Mia.
For you anymore.
Yeah.
And now I want to see a little trot. Just run with your body until she starts to follow your body language. Try it. Ask her and tell her, trot. Good girl. Use a lot of praise because that makes it easier.
I disagree with that. You don't want to use a lot of praise. You want to keep your mouth shut. More talking is not good. This is where my big problem with a lot of women are. They think talking is good. Talking is not good with horses. I don't care if you guys want to talk on the phone for 6 hours or go have wine and drink. I don't care. With horses, it's not good.
Then she says, oh, that was hard. Just go get her again. It was just a hard thing to do. And try it again. Slowly trot. Good girl. That's right. Talk to her all the time. Good.
Do not talk to your horse. Mia, stop talking. I like your accent. I like your voice, but I don't want to hear it with horses, and a horse doesn't want to hear it.
Good girl. Yeah, come on. Yeah, good girl. Talk to her around the corner. Good girl. That's right. Exactly. And stop.
So this girl is softer. I can tell by her first pat that she's softer with her horse. Mia thinks that aggressiveness is strength or power or dominance. This girl is soft, but she doesn't understand how to control the feet and get the horse to respect her. So softness is good, You don't have to be aggressive and mean. And I'm not saying Mia's mean, but she slaps a damn horse too much, and a horse doesn't like that.
And tell me, how does it feel?
Great.
Do you understand it? What's happening?
Yeah.
At least she's got her whiskers. I think I see her whiskers. They didn't trim her whiskers.
What do you think about riding this horse without a bit on?
It's not what I don't want to do at home when I have a
I think you need to move your chair. Oh, you can do it. Great. Okay. Okay.
Horse's tail immediately gets active.
Oh, you can do it.
Great. Immediately gets active.
Okay. Okay.
Starts turning that head. I think this is a what I call setup for failure. I would not put an inexperienced rider who's already problems with a horse in this situation this quick. I like that Mia is not timid and says, you can do it and we're moving forward. I like that she's not too wimpy in that area, but I don't think it's productive to teach the horse a good lesson or the rider, because this could go bad. And I don't want to set things up with a new rider or new horse or something that I'm trying to teach, and I don't want to set the horse up to fail. And when I say set the horse up to fail, is I put it in a situation to where it can make a mistake and bad lessons are learned.
Okay. No, and you can't either, because she's a jumping horse and you need the bit in the sport, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So her reins are a little looser. She seems a little tense. Maya had a little bit more relaxed seat. I can tell she's a little stiffer.
What do you feel? Do you feel like she is relaxed?
Yeah, a lot.
A lot.
Yeah. It's a much more relaxed horse.
Yeah.
That was actually a pretty nice stop. Good job.
And that's very useful for me.
How was it for you to ride her without a bit in?
No, it was different, because when I ride her at home, I should hold her like this whole time, because then if
because you're scared, you're insecure, and you probably ride her in a bigger area. When you train a horse in a small area, don't think because this horse does this here that I can now take it out in the open country and ride like this. There is not enough of a routine established and control and leadership role that you can walk out in a big area right now. Another big mistake people make. Oh, my horse will do this? Oh, let's go for a ride. Bad move.
If I not do it, she just run away.
Yeah.
And that's not I.
And today you could let go of it.
Both of these two need to work on one rein stop, or watch my video on one rein, riding with one rein. Very, very critical to teach you how hard your hands are and to teach softness. You have to learn softness when you ride with one rein. Otherwise, you go in circles.
Your reins and let your horse relax.
Yeah, and she just walk with me and not go.
And she listens to you.
Yeah.
Okay, so Mia, hopefully you don't hate me. If you do, that's okay. I think some people will learn from this. Some people will learn to hate me more. Some people will learn what I said is true, and some people, hell, may even like me because I'm taking up for the horse. But it's never the horse's fault. Never. All right. We'll end that there on Mia, the Dutch show jumping horse trainer, whatever, extraordinaire. All right. We got an email. Somebody email Mia this video or this series. I'll make this a 3-part series. Y'all have a good one. This little horse, I don't know the horse's name. It's a great little horse. Beautiful horse. Really a lot of try. This is not a horse problem. Mia did, look, she did okay. She's not the worst trainer. She didn't ruin the horse. She didn't hurt the horse. She could have been softer and more effective. That's basically what I'm saying. I'm just pointing it out, and it probably sounds worse than it is. All right? Mia, I don't hate you. And we'll end that there.